The bromance is probably, there's so much of the show, you know? I love, one of my favorite parts of the show is the relationship between McGarrett and Dano, you know? I really feel that that's kind of the glue for the whole thing. And so I miss it when he's not there, and you know, but we always fill it with other interesting things, you know? Stuff with Doris McGarrett was, it's terrific, and it's sort of left in limbo at the moment. You know, you guys all know what's happening, and it's. I mean, that's great for me as an actor because it gives me. It's really great character stuff. You know, it's the fuel that's sort of burning away behind everything else he does. That's the nice serialized character stuff I get to sink my teeth into. I don't think I own a pair of cargo pants, let alone, you know, many pairs that I would need to count. I do, however, have cargo shorts. I'm a big G-Star cargo short guy, you know, kind of always have been. They're my go-to. Oh my God, probably in a public restroom is probably one of the more strange places. But you know where it's gotten to now is that people don't ask me to say it anymore, they just tell me to do it. You know, it's like, yo, book him down. I'm like, well, I'm McGarrett, but okay, thanks. So it's just, you know, it's just people like the opportunity to be able to say that line because it's so famous. He's pretty different. I mean, we both have a tenacity, you know, we both have a kind of a I'm pretty disciplined. Me, Alex, you know, I'm in with most things. And so I share that with him. And of course, aspects of who I am, I play this guy every day, year after year, of aspects of who I am, of, you know, are gonna sort of show up in him. But ultimately, you know, he's kind of like he's much sort of less emotional than I am. He's much sort of tougher and smarter, and all my characters are usually, you know, more of a person, man, and more of a, you know, everything than I am. That's a tough question because, you know, it's, you know, we're into our fourth year and there's so much water under the bridge, and I think the moments that episodes like 320, I think it was, which is the episode where McGarrett goes back to Korea. We do a big flashback episode, and his SEAL buddy gets killed. And I mean, that sort of stuff is fantastic for me to do because it feels, in some way, like a departure away from the sort of daily grind of formula television. And it's all based in character. And so I'm never gonna not wanna do that. I'm always gonna wanna do character. It's just my nature, that's why I'm an actor. And so anytime they let me do those things, you know, stuff with my family is always, with McGarrett's family is always fun. But also, you know, there's been, you know, yeah, those moments along the way are the ones that really sort of shine for me and help me get through the rest to the next moment like that. Okay, I'm listening to this new guy out of England. He's an English artist, and his name's King Krule, with a K. K-R-U-L-E, I think you spell it. He's really interesting. He's kind of like young Clash. He's like the Clash when they first started, but sort of deconstructed. He's kind of bizarre, too. Like, some of his songs, I go, this is awesome. Some of his songs, I go, wow, it's weird. Yeah, I get cast to play, like, you know, hero dudes, I guess. You know, maybe I've got a look that fits that or something. I think the older I get, the less I want to do, the more I want to play characters with less redeeming qualities, because there's a lot of really interesting people out there, and I'm kind of interested in us as humans and what makes us who we are. I mean, no. The answer is no. Aside from the travel time it takes me to get there and back each day, the North Shore is probably one of my favorite places to film because I love it up there. It's the country, you know, side of the island, and It's very raw and it's very kind of wild, you know, and the ocean's wild and big. And so that's when we get to go up there, it's, you know, I'm always in a slightly calmer headspace. And my other favorite place is on stage, because the days are more controlled, you know what I mean? I mean, you know, when you work as much as we do, to actually get to set and to do 12 hours and no more and get to go home, I mean, that's a fantastic day. Oh, you know, I mean, about Australia, I miss people more than anything. You know, wherever I am, there's circles of friends that I have in different parts of the world and that I yearn for occasionally. You know, we miss our people, and we're gregarious herd animals, you know, humans. And so that's the main thing that I miss. My main people, like my kids and my partner, are with me now, so that's, you know, but all my family are over there and I miss them, you know, and I miss seeing my sister's having a baby pretty soon, and you know what I mean? I probably won't be there for that, those sorts of things. But as far as LA, which I lived here for a really long time, you know, before I went to Hawaii, the main things I miss about here, the main things I miss about the rest of the world living on an island are live music, because there's not very much live music there, and I miss music. I'd love more restaurants. I'd love if there was more. We're so spoiled for choice here in Los Angeles. On every corner, there's fantastic sushi, great Italian. There's all these award-winning chefs. These little, you know, and it's a little more limited there. But the food there is very good, you know. And so it's more sort of lifestyle stuff, I think. Hi, Diana. Thank you for your support over all these years. I have actually thought about writing memoirs. Not so much, well, kind of. But it's not about my acting life. It's more about my entire life, you know. But to be perfectly honest, I don't think my entire life is interesting enough for a memoir. But I have had a lot of really interesting experiences in my life. And met a lot of interesting people and had a lot of odd and interesting coincidences and stuff, and so I often feel like I'd like to incorporate them into a film. So You Think You Can Dance? I love it so much. I love it so much. I dream about it. Listen, I don't care if the world knows. This is the thing. I DVR it. If I don't get to watch it within like 72 hours of the DVRing, I get extremely grumpy. I get short with the kids. I get short with people at work. I have to watch it. And I get very emotional when it's on. When people get cut, I get a little upset. I have been known to get a bit misty.